Hello guys, and welcome back to another Jet Vlog. Now today we're going to be, well, I'm going to be working on the growing chamber, no, the dehydration chamber, my bad. I have until 1:35 when I have math, so we'll start working on this. Shouldn't take too long because we've got the core set up, and picking up from last episode, I did fix the model. So if I just run our game and I can show you what I did. So essentially the problem with the rendering was I found out that if you have a block up against, if you have like a block up against another block in the model renderer, then it will actually not render that the part that is being covered by the other block, because just for efficiency issues, but because it's glass, it shouldn't be doing that, but that's just how the program was made. So what I did, and it looks even better now, is time set day, and so it turns, so it works in all directions, as you can see. So here, wait, let me just do this. Oh, no. Let's go over here. This. And you can see the models are working perfectly. And actually, the glass is not... there's a space between the glass and the shelves. And when you break it, it has all the particle effects. And when you enter it, it has the actual slot. Okay, so now we just have to make it work. So this should be relatively easy. I can't emphasize that enough. So actually the hard part's gonna get it to do the loading thing. So what we need to do, so much like the growing chamber, so let's go to the growing chamber, and although we want to go to this GUI thing, and we're gonna want to do another, so we're gonna do this exact thing. So let's just do that and go in the dehydration chamber, and we can just paste that, and we can just delete that, and of course we want to have another string, and we'll say progress percent equals to t.get. Okay, you know what, let's just do this for now. Okay, I don't know why I could have just done this. There we go. Okay. So now we actually do want to go into... Oh, string.val... Okay, t.growingTime. So we're going to want to go into the tile entity. Oh, and let me just make sure the tile... Yes, dehydration chamber. So just go in here. And if we go down to the update method, we're going to want to make two variables like we did last time. It's going to be the... public int progress percent, right? Is that what it was? Nope, wait. Growing chamber. Growing time. So in this case, it's going to be dehydration time equals to zero, and then we're going to want a private int called gear reduction. And we'll set that to can't type today equals to zero. So that was called reduction gear. That's what it's called. Reduction gear. Okay. So now, so we only have two slots. So the first slot is the one in the middle, and that's slot index zero. And the second one is one. Okay. So that means that we want to get the first and second slot. Okay. So let's say, okay, so actually in here, in the growing chamber, we do want to, I just realized something. So let's say there's an item inside of the output slot, and what we do is we do set inventory slot contents to one, slot one. Wait, is it one? Oh, we're gonna wanna change this to 2 now, right? Wait. Okay, you know what? Before we okay, we'll work on that after that. After. So we have slot 0 and 1, right? So we're gonna have if okay, no. Okay. If this dot get stack and slot index 0 equals does not equal to null, and this dot get stack and slot 1 does not equal to null. So now and if it equals it's not okay. So if it equals to okay, sorry. Okay. If stack and slot 0 does not equal to null, okay, 1 second. And this dot stack and slot 0, stack and slot 1, equals, does not equal to null. And then we're gonna want to do this, and then we're gonna want to put another if statement that says this, if this dot get stack and slot 1. Oh, wait, dot get item, does not equal to, what is it, prunes, so mod items dot prunes, then we're just gonna return. Otherwise, we're gonna say, okay, we're gonna do the update, so, then we're gonna say, the reduction gear, so if okay, no. Okay, if the stack and slot does not equal to prunes, then we're just gonna want to return, and we'll say dehydration time equals to 0 and reduction gear equals to 0. Okay, so if, okay, and then otherwise, else if this dot get stack and slot. So in this case, we're not gonna need this. Okay, no, that's wrong. That is wrong. If it does not equal to... What do I have in here? Okay, that. Okay, wait, let's redo that. If it does not equal to null. And this dot get stack. Fuck. Okay. If this dot get stack. Okay, so we're actually gonna wanna delete this. Right. Delete that, and then we're gonna say if this dot get stack in slots 1 equals does not equal to null. Or this dot get stack in slot 1 equals to prunes mod items dot prunes dot get item. We're gonna want to put get item as well. So if it is not null. Okay, wait, no. If it is null. No, if it's not null, end it. God damn it. Come on, logic, Lorcan, logic. Okay. If the stack in slot 1 does not have nothing in it. Okay, so these essentially. Oh no, so we're gonna put. If it is null and doesn't have prunes in it. So if slot 1 is null. Or it has prunes. Fuck, I got to think. Okay, I can't, for some reason, I'm not thinking straight. If the output has nothing in it, or there are prunes in it, okay, there we go. Then we're gonna do that. So now, we're gonna say, if this dot gets stack in slot 0, dot get item equals to plums, no, mod items dot plums equals to a plum, then we're gonna say, and if it doesn't, we're just gonna say dehydration time equals to 0 and reduction gear equals to 0. Okay. So, if it doesn't have a plum, okay, that's right, and then we do. And then, in this if statement, if it does have a plum, then we're going to say reduction gear plus plus. And if the reduction gear if the remainder of the reduction gear divided by we'll do, you know what, let's do 75 again. Now let's do 50. 50 equals to 0. Then we're gonna say dehydration time plus plus. And then we check if dehydration time is greater or equal to if it's greater or equal to 100, then we are going to do set inventory slot contents. No. Dot clear. Right? No. Okay, get stack and slot 0 dot delete dot erase. Okay, how did I do this before? In the toilet. But I did this up here. The block toilet. Oh, did I seriously just decrease the stack size? Oh wait, no, I just removed the stack from the slot. That remove stack from slot 0. But before we do that, we are going to want to do this dot set inventory slot contents for 1. And then we're going to create a new item stack. And that's going to be prunes. Item stack mod items dot prunes. And then the amount is going to be, it's going to be this dot. Get stack in slot 0 dot stack size. All right, so now if we go into here, we can say TE dot dehydration time, right? And of course we're gonna wanna do string dot value of this. And then we want to actually go into the planting. Okay, wait, first let's run this, make sure. See if we get any errors. Ooh, no. What? Oh, wait, I know. So just like we did with the growing chamber. Wait, what? So if it is null, we'll just say dehydration time equals to 0, and then reduction gear equals to 0. Okay, so let's now check on the crash report. There's null pointer exception line 217, of course it was. 217 right here. What exactly was null? Maybe if we do this. Okay. Oh, it's going up. That's good. If we put something in here, it doesn't go up, that's perfect. If we take it out, okay, it goes up again. And now if we get some prunes, goddammit, prunes. Okay, it's still going up. Okay, now, let's just get some more plums. Let's get some more plums, put that in there. Okay, now we just wait. Okay, now we just wait, so I think we're good. Whoops. 33. Okay, now I just gotta make sure that... Okay, it is going up, so it's at 35 right now. Now, if we go fuck around with that skeleton. How's that not... It was standing under one block over here. Right here. Right there. That's why I was surviving. Okay, so it was at 35 now. Must be up 44. Perfect. It's going up even when I'm away and not looking at it. Of course, with the growing chamber, we want to make the same precautions. So if stack in slot 1 equals to null... Oh, no, no, we already did it. Okay, so just as long as there's nothing in there, we're good. It's at 59%. 60, so I'll come back once it's loaded up. I'm going to pause the recording. Alright, I'm an idiot. I forgot to unpause the recording when it happened, but it happened. It worked. And we have prunes. Yay. Now, what I'm curious to see is, what if we already have prunes in here? And actually, to do this, you know what, let's speed up the growth time. So, if it is instead... Is this recording? If it's instead... You know what, let's just put it at 5... for now. Well, you can change it back. So let's run it. So single player test. Okay, so now what I do want to test is, what if I have, alright, let's take some plums, so I'll just take 64, and let's say that we have 32 prunes in here, and we put in plums in here, so now it's going up really quickly. What's it gonna do? Okay, once it hits 100, I have no clue what's gonna happen. Is it gonna crash? No, it just gives you 64. Okay. So, then another thing we can say is, if stack and slot... Wait a minute. This is saying if stack and slot equals to plum. So does that... Oh, never mind. Okay, wait, sorry. Exit out. So, now if we say... Okay, You know what? We can just leave it at that. Who cares? I think we're good. We made it fully functioning and everything works well. So now what I do want to figure out is the fertilizer stuff. So for the recipe, so let's go to our recipe handler. For our recipe, and let's go over here to food recipes, we can see it uses wheat, fertilizer, and milk. And then the growing chamber uses plum seeds and fertilizer, but I wanted to make it cow fertilizer. Do we have cow fertilizer recipe? Just the toilet. Okay, wait, let's go to the toilet. When we click it, new stack, new item, stack, fertilizer, meta zero. Alright, so. Okay, now I do have that. If it has toilet paper, fertilizer. Okay. So yeah, that I've got to figure out. That I have to make it so that in the growing chamber, it needs to be cow fertilizer. So let me just test something out. If it is a new item stack. Okay, wait, let me just see something. Item, nope. Alright, so let's just leave it as that for now, and I'll get back to you in the next video. Goodbye.